All right, my friends, we've got another video here. This one we're going to go over another feature of Lychee. You should have seen some videos on how to modify supports, how to change your resin settings. This one's going to go over some of the more advanced features with moving things around, generating supports. So the first thing to note is you notice that right now I'm in classic mode and I'm not selected on the model. That's why the model itself is gray. So if your model is gray and yellow, you're not on the model. You click the model. If the model is blue and yellow, that means the model is targeted. And when you're in classic mode, you can basically just drop supports and it will auto draw them like that. If you are in advanced mode though, you can't just click and draw. You have to use either Alt. So if I'm holding Alt, you notice I get that gray line thing again and I double click and it drops the support. But this is where it gets fun. While holding Alt, if you click once, and then click once again on another support, it'll draw from the model to a support. You can also, again holding Alt, click from support to support. And you can, again holding Alt, click from support to model. And this will always generate a kinked support if you're holding just the Alt button. You can also hold Alt and, let's see, Alt. And put it exactly where you want in terms of the kink. So like, let's say I want to kink over to here versus there. As long as I'm holding Alt, it'll let me draw to wherever I want. You can also hold Alt and draw straight. Like, sometimes it won't draw straight to the ground and you need to do it yourself. So you can just hold Alt and draw straight to the ground. And Alt and Control is what draws mini supports. So you hold the Alt button and the Control button, you click once, and then you click wherever you want to go. Now, right now, mine is drawing these as cones because I was messing with variables before. So if that happens to happen for you, it's no big deal. You just come over here to Base Tip, and you set those dimensions to match whatever your tip dimensions are. So in this case, it's 24, so we just either drag or click once and type it to 24. And then now we have our regular supports back again. Alternatively, you can click off the model and then just choose one of your preset supports and then Alt and click, or Alt and Control at the same time, and it will draw a mini-to-mini support. Mini-to-mini supports can also be drawn between the different pillars. Now, on these kinked supports, let's say that I want to, you know, get up over to here. I can actually click and holding the Alt button. So I'm right clicking while holding Alt and then drawing to where I want. And you know, those are okay, but they're not exactly optimal. But you notice that I have the little blue dots on this support, but not on this support. If I click that support, suddenly I have the blue dots. It just makes it very easy to edit and modify things. Blue ball joints will always move only their section. So you notice that I'm making all of these moves with the blue ball joint, but it's not affecting the tip at all. And that can be very, very helpful. Learning to use this little gizmo is also super helpful. If you don't have any experience with it, it can be a little bit weird in the beginning. Camera angle matters a lot. But it's incredibly powerful being able to draw your supports exactly as you want. Now you see these little squares that are around the edges. These squares are scale factors, so they allow you to scale the element of the support that you're highlighted on, basically arbitrarily, up and down. They're definitely worth playing with. Each one does do a different thing, and you can scale tips, ball joints, and sections. And each one is going to scale things just slightly differently. It's definitely worth playing around with. That is about it. So again, Alt single click will generate kink supports, either or straight supports between two models or two support pillars, and then Alt and Control will generate mini support tips. If you want to turn those mini support tips into clones that are more stable or to cones that are more stable, you come over to Base Tip and you just throw that over to a larger value. It remembers, Lychee remembers, so the reason it keeps coming back to these is because when I click this support right here, because I made support cones off of it, that's why it keeps making the support cones. That's actually super useful. It remembers. All right, thank you so much.